quickly get things started. Cause we ain't got no time to waste. I don't mind. Hey, what is up, guys? Before we get started, make sure you guys put in the code. It's going to be on screen for you. This will be for the chest for anyone that's wondering. Astromancer, that's what it is. So you get your three leaves and your 300,000 gold. So let's go ahead and jump into Lua's preview. I'm pretty excited for this, so let's go ahead and get into it.
If you just do what I say, you can have everything your heart desires. You weak, pitiful thing. Suffer an eternity of pain. It's all going according to plan.
So I kind of figured she would be a ranger, so I'm not that surprised. I kind of figured they do Bologna's thing. She has critical hit chance for the friend imprint. That's awesome. I could definitely use that. So let's see what she does.
She was an ordinary girl born heard a mysterious.
Alright, so she's got 120 speed here naturally, it looks like. That's kind of nice. Did I miss anything important? No. I'm just gonna skip some of the lore. I'm not really interested in the lore. She's got a fan. So she, yeah, the figures. She's a little like blowing up. So let's see what she does here. So she is a Pisces Ranger. I think that's how you said that. So she's got effectiveness in her self imprint, and she's got a critical hit chance imprint for the team. Nice, getting dupes her could be pretty helpful if she is very good. 120 speed, 611 defense, 15% crit chance, 150 defense, or critical hit damage, 109, 993 attack, 6002 health. These are pretty good stats, actually, I think. The speed looks pretty solid. So what does she do? When I mean solid, I mean for a ranger. Let's see what she does. So let's go into her skill introduction. So this is her S2, Butterfly, how do you pronounce that?
Skill 2, Butterfly Reverie.
Reverie, okay. So attacks the enemy with a light, dispelling two buffs before putting them to sleep for one turn. Grants an extra turn to the caster. Oh my goodness, she sounds like Elfit. Acquires two souls, four turn cooldown. Wait, this is her alternate? No, this is her skill 2. Damage increase. So she's just going to sleep the enemy and dispel two buffs. That's pretty toxic. I like it. What does she do here? Her S3 is called Sweet Talk. Dispel one buff from all enemies before casting a skill cooldown before increasing skill cooldown by one turn and inflicting... What?
After dispelling one buff from all enemies, increases skill cooldowns by one turn and beguiles for one turn. Increases speed of all allies for two turns.
Beguile? What the hell is that? So beguile at the end of the turn deals additional damage to the allies of the target except for the target, equivalent to 10% of their respective max health. Jeez, I just woke up. Beguile effects applies to heroes only and is dispelled once the effect is active. Increases speed of all allies for two turns. Oh boy, oh boy. This dispels... That seems pretty good. Dispels one buff from all allies. Or from all enemies. So she's removing buffs. Increasing the cooldowns. And giving you speed. She deals additional damage to all allies. Deals additional damage to all allies of the target. Except for the target equivalent to 10% of their respective max health. She sounds better than Bologna. Excuse me, Bologna got an upgrade?
Beguile. At the end,
give me a second.
Is equivalent to 10% of their respective max health.
Wait,
the Beguile effect applies to heroes only and is dispelled once the effect is activated.
She also stealths? What? Skill 1. Holding fan. She's literally Bologna, but limited. Attacks the enemy with a fan with a 40% chance to decrease defense for two turns. She's Bologna. She's just better Bologna. Excuse me? That's sick. She seems pretty good. What does her artifact do? I wanted something that was similar to Guiding Light, so let's see what we got. Increases effectiveness by 20% after using a non-attack skill, has a 50% chance to grant stealth to the ally, except for the caster with the highest attack for two turns. Can only be activated once every four turns. At max, it's going to give you 100% chance to grant... It is Guiding Light. It's just the support mode Guiding Light for... What? Why? Why do we need another... Oh, fake. This is a fake Guiding Light, guys. It's fake. But it gives her an effectiveness. What the heck? Hold on, we gotta rewind a second. So that's gonna help with this, and then that's gonna also help with what does her other skill do? Sleep? But I think the sleep is guaranteed, is it not? I guess it could technically resist it. It's interesting. It's definitely interesting. Did we see her ultimate already?
Activated once every four turns. Oh, the alluring tactician who spreads a forgotten chaos.
I love her ult.
Players will be able to meet Lua in the drop rate up banner starting October 6th.
So here in like a week. Not even a week. Yeah, about a week. Oh, that's so cool. Do they show her ultimate off?
Somebody forgot their place. Aw, you weak, pitiful thing. Suffer an eternity.
Dude, she's
pain.
So villainous.
Focus.
Oh, her ult doesn't actually do damage. That's so cool. It's got the beguile effect with sleep. That's so toxic. I like it. I like it. So is she designed to be like a tankier ranger? Excuse me? This is just showing her fight.
Guiding light. Illuminate the unknown.
I can do it.
With them showing off Lionheart here, maybe she's getting her rerun next?
Be filled with bitter cold.
Just speculating.
Do I look like a pushover to you? You're not too strong, so this should be enough.
Are you sure you can handle this? A lion never relents.
So.
No matter how small its prey. Come on, I'll take you all.
You really want your blood spilled?
Yes.
So be it.
She teleports. Oh, it's so cool. I love how they managed to get the defense break off, guys. It's 40%, unless there's actually like bonuses in there.
Lucky.
Exhausted already? I'm just getting started.
Annoying. Must be crushed.
I'm already sold on her. She looks really good already.
Your dead comrade.
Music box, what the heck?
Are waiting for you.
Do it again.
It looks like somebody forgot their place.
Instead of she defense
sure
broke again.
You can handle this? This is getting exciting.
This is rigged.
You're not half bad.
Yeah, we get it, Lionheart. So make it broken.
Disappear through the cracks of time and space. I'll be the one deciding how this all ends.
You weak, pitiful thing. Suffer an eternity of pain.
That's so cool.
This is it.
So I think your X2 makes it to where you're able to counter out like units like Politis because you sleep them, right? Is that what she did? She used her S2. This is her S2 before putting them attacks the enemy with a light display. Yeah, this is makes it to where you can safely go into Politis. Obviously, you need to outspeed her, but that's really cool because she gets a so you sleep the Politis and then you grant the extra skill and you go into your S3. Which would be this. That's really cool. She's an awesome ranger support. Now I understand. So that's sick. So what were her stats again? Where's her stat page at? Right there. I don't know who to compare this to, because I'm not sure if we have a ranger like this, but that's pretty cool. She does have quite a bit of health now that I'm looking at it. Her health's kind of up there. Decent attack. I was actually the scenario I thought. She looks all around pretty solid. Maybe she's a bit slower now that I'm thinking about it. I don't know. I don't really know how fast rangers should be. I'd have to check Landy. I think Landy's speed is similar to this, I think. She looks pretty cool, and she's got a crit chance for the team. I need to get one extra dupe of her, I think, just to get the crit chance to help my to help me out. I'm going for her. I'll probably go for a dupe, too, if it's not too much to ask. But yeah, I'm definitely going to get her. I think she looks pretty cool as a supportive ranger. That's sick. All right, guys, let's jump over to the patch notes real fast because there is more stuff to go over. Is this the patch notes? No, this is the patch notes. Oh, wait, I have to hit this. We'll close this out and go to here. Wow, sorry, I was stuck on her a sec. I was starstruck by how cool she is. So they are going through the balances. I don't think anything's changed. So Straz will be getting his buff. This is for, yeah, Straz, the Star Extinction, so enhanced skill, I think the only thing is changing is that, Okay, so attacks all enemies with a sword, penetrates defense with the target's highest max health by 30%. When the caster's attack is greater than the penetration attack, increase up to the difference, the maximum grants spins, believe it or not. So did they revert it then, or are they... Will change and his penetration rate will be... Oh yeah, they're keeping the Shiraz buff. Okay, so the effect of Demon Blood will be changed. Yes, we know this. She's gonna get some extra start of turn fighting spirit on Ravi, and then the effectiveness and attacks going up to 15%. And then she's getting penetration on her S3, I think this is what it is. So that's cool. Her thing is has a 70% chance to make the enemy. Yep, that's still the same. We've already gone over the buffs already. I'm just checking if they changed anything. This is for Chiron, so the AoE counter is still here. When the attack is not triggered and has a chance to counter, the skill changes into... Yeah, it's still AoE counter. Okay, invasion, still the same. This is for Arya, and when the... It's not the caster's turn effect. Yep, that's still the same. So did they actually go through and take out this? They did. They did. But they made it to where the damage is all equaled out, I think. So, yeah. I will see how that plays off. We'll see. This is still the same. So all the buffs seemed, and the nerfs seem to go through. Okay, so everything went through. That's cool. Yeah. Interesting. They didn't really care. Okay, cool. So we're getting a new episode 4, chapter 9, Wicked Land. Ooh, there's a cat lady on the cover. That's interesting. So we'll be getting a new map to farm for some sky stones. That's cool. We have 50 sky stones out of the main reward. Let's see here. I don't really know if this matters too much. Completing 910, Fate Belt and Wicked Land will unlock a mission to awaken Aiden. I have yet to even really do this, to be honest. Summary Syria and Straz, or Sez is getting ran. Just for a fast breakdown, Sez is a skip, and now that we see that there's a new character on the way, I would say Syria is probably an easy skip, because you should be re-rolling for her if you're brand new on your re-roll summons and not have to worry about her. However, Song of Stars is a good artifact for Wyvern on the unit Furious, so if you don't have that, you could powder it, but honestly, with how strong Lua's artifact seems to be, I don't even think it's worth it. But if you're brand new to the game, and yet you didn't re-roll for if you didn't re-roll for Syria, she is good for PvE. Just know that there's a lot more things coming this month, so I think it's a safe skip, because you can always pick her up later down the road, where this unit could be a new limited that we're getting. So honestly, I think both these banners are skipped, because Lua looks like she could be in Lost Summon, depending on what she's looking like in-game, obviously. So we do have Politis and whoever this is in the... Okay, this doesn't matter. It's mainly for whale stuff. Lucky Week Dash Pack. Do not get this. This thing is a ripoff. Let's see. Deanna's skin will be added to the... Okay, so you can just pick it up. Wow, it's actually an epic skin. Who knew? Battle adjustments, they will be made to values, NPC supports will be... Okay, so they're adjusting the... Oh, I guess you can see your Mola now. That's cool. Improvements have been made about the energy leaf and skystone displayed on the pop-up banner during repeat battle. Okay. Improvements have been made that the set hero's impression also apply to hero's profile and the battle result. Oh, okay, so it comes over to the MVP screen. The feature will allow players to view artifacts in more details. Okay. Yeah, that's for who cares. Okay, cool. So, yeah, that's cool. Lua looks like she could be potentially a must summon. She does look very good. The fact that she's doing a lot of things to help out with countering Politis just makes me interested in her. And on top of it, she is increasing speed too, so that's really sick. Yeah, she looks really good. We'll see what she does in game. She does look kind of like a support ranger, which is interesting. And her artifact does look to be an artifact that you might want to get a couple of dupes of, because it is a 50% chance to cloak an ally, I think, at level 15. So you might want to get a couple of dupes to make it more consistent. And then I guess before we wrap up, once again, if you guys missed the code is right here, Astromancer. So that's going to be it for this video. I'm excited for her. I probably will summon for her. I might go for a dupe just for that extra imprint. But I could always just imprint her down the line. So we'll see. If I pull her early, I might do another pull on her. I don't know. I should probably preserve because the slime collaboration's on the way, and so is Arunka, but that critical chance and print does have me like thirsting a bit. So yeah, that's gonna be it for this video, guys. Hope you enjoyed it, and yeah, good luck on your summons. Remember to skip Iceria and Cez, and yeah, we'll see how good she is when she drops. I am looking forward to Lua. I think she looks really good and interesting, so I'll talk to y'all later. Peace.